Who shall abide in thy tabernacle? Who shall dwell in thy holy hill? He that walketh uprightly and worketh righteousness and speaketh the truth in his heart. He that backbiteth not with his tongue, nor doeth evil to his neighbor, nor taketh up a reproach against his neighbor, in whose eyes a vile person is condemned. But he that honoreth them, he honoreth them that fear the Lord. He sweareth to his own hurt and changeth not. He that putteth not out his money to usury, nor taketh reward against the innocent, he that doeth these things shall never be moved.
So this is who will be in the house of the Lord. And this was written by
David,
the house of David. So I like the last one, which says, he that does not give out money on usury, right? So you don't, if you give out £100 to someone who's in trouble, you don't say, right, that's £130 I want back, £30 interest on that for helping you out. And I also like halfway through, he that condemns evil, right? So we should not condone evil, we should do the opposite. I think that's so important to read again. Did you read that again, Tony? What John read?
Nor does evil to his neighbor.
Not that one.
In whose eyes a vile person is despised.
Yeah, in whose eyes a vile person is despised. So you should despise a vile person. Are you with me?
Yeah.
And the next line after it is the opposite.
But he honors those who fear the Lord.
So you honor those that fear the Lord, and you despise those that are evil. So we are supposed to despise evil. You know, this modern, oh, we've got to let everybody, whether they're a transsexual, lesbian, bank robber that kicks old ladies out, but we still have that. You know, that's not displacing evil, is it? You know, anyway. So, who will be in the house of the Lord? We went back to David's house, and I think John and Sheena were away, or maybe not, when I did this one. That was the Star of David. And there were 37 black dots in it. Yeah? This was the magnificence of the Genesis 1:1. And there were 36 red dots, 6 on each of the 6 points, 36. So we had 36 plus 37 black, gave us a total of 73. So geometry wise, gematria is the Hebrew for geometry. Gematria wise, there were 73 in the Star of David, okay? And then we went through, I think this was a few weeks back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 times in Genesis 1:1 where it says, and God said, okay? And God said, he spoke it into creation. And that was Yamar Elohim, okay? Which we did it numerically, it came out 257 plus 86 for the Elohim, which was a total of 343, which is 86 plus 257, 86 plus 257 was 343. And then with our calculator, we worked out 7 by 7 by 7 was 43. Now, I've looked at this again on another level, there's another level to that. This here, on day one, it says, and God said, day two, and God said. Day three, there were two and God saids, okay? Day four, one and God said. Day five, and God said. Then the sixth day, the pinnacle of his creation, is let us make man in our image, isn't it? And there's three and God says, all right? There's an and God said, an and God said, and an and God said. Yeah? You with me?
Yeah.
Yeah, there's the only... I say no, you created the heavens and the earth. But you know, he created one, twice, and God said, one, three. Okay? So we've got, and God said, which was 777, the Father, the Son,
and the Holy Spirit.
Let's make God in our image. 2-1, 2-3-3-1, that totals up to 777777. Okay, which brings me to this week. Who was not taking usury. Now, does anyone know, if something rises uniform, it means that this week we had one person in the fellowship, and then next week two, and then three, then four, then five, then six, it'd be growing uniformly. It's a straight line graph going up. Now, people say, oh no, but that's growing exponentially. You've all heard the word.
Yeah.
What it means is, Tony comes on week one, he comes on his own, then he brings John, but he brings John, and John brings his friend Derek, so you've now got three. Next week, he brings his friend, John brings his friend, he's found someone else, he's got six. And then you've got like 15 the next week, and they're all getting their friends to go. Before you know, it's sort of grown exponentially, hasn't it? It hasn't grown bit by bit, it's grown exponentially. And that's what, I'll come to that in a minute with interest, but that's what population growth does, isn't it? If you have a family, you take their mum and dad and the children, say they have three, four children, suddenly have one or two, and then you go down to, oh, we've got 15 grandchildren, 20 great-grandchildren. I think the Saudi, Bin Laden, he was the 17th son, I think, the 19th son, so you can imagine how many daughters and then grandchildren came out of that. So, it's grown exponentially. Now, if we take the 6,000 years, okay, of mankind, this being the start, 2,000, I went roughly 2,000, was it, when Abraham said you've got to circumcise your children on the eighth day. 4,000 years when Christ came, and then he rose on the eighth day, and then we await the second coming 2,000 years later. So, broadly speaking, I mean, I'm amusing approximately, 2,000, 4,000, 6,000. Yeah? Now, we all know, in Noah's day, how many people survived the ark?
Eight.
Noah, his wife, Ham and his wife, Shem and his wife, Japheth and his wife. So, here it goes, growing exponentially up, and then boom. 1,656 years after creation, God intervenes, so that it's got so wicked, all these get wiped out. It's probably not quite the same, but there was probably millions of people on earth at that time. There's a number of children they had, no contraception. So here, it's gone back down to eight people left. So God started with none, raised Adam and Eve, off it went, boom, back down to eight. So off we go again to Abraham. It's growing here like this, growing. At Christ time, they reckon after Christ died, and then the apostles preached the good news, at the end of all the apostles died, one in every 360 people were Christians. So they were still sparse, you know what I mean? We think it's not many today, but it was sparse then. So here we have the population. You've got Ham, Shem and Japheth. Everyone know where they went? Which area is which? Ham, the Hamites went down to Africa, for Libya and all that. The Shemites are the Jews and the Arabs, the Middle East of the Levant. And then Asia, Europe is the Japhethites. That was generally the Japhethite Europe. So they spread out, off they go, here's Christ, and they go out preaching the good news. So that's the gospel spread, but also the population spread. And I was looking at how it's grown since about, 1800. It's phenomenal. Yeah. I mean, we're only talking about 1 billion, 2 billion people here. We're now up to 7,000 million, I'm going to call it a billion. But 7,000 million people on Earth, about 7,002 actually now. Now Islam, for instance, in 1930 was 200 million, it's now 1,800 million. So it's gone up 9 times since 1930. So that's what's called exponential growth, so it's growing beyond a regular growth. Now, God says he's going to step in again here. You get the rapture. And God blacks out the revelation. What's the revelation scripture of that? Is it?
Greek the other day, or Archon, but in Hebrew,
it's Sar. So he's Sar Shalom. He's the Prince of Peace. He's our Sar Shalom.
Okay.
Now, obviously, God deducted all the numbers behind all this. She is the last of one letter because Tau is the end. T is 400. So that's 300. Resh is the letter before, which is 200. That's the Sar bit. So that adds up to 500. The Prince means 500. Shalom is Sheen 300. Lamed. Vav, and then Shalom, which is 376. Now, if we're doing that, adding the prince to the piece, you get the Prince of Peace, you get 500 plus 376, which is
876.
876, there. Now, 876 just happens to be the godly number of heaven, 12, times 73, which was the numbers on the Star of David. So he's in the house of David, because he created the house of David. He is the son of David. He was there eternally from the start before he came there, right? And if you think that's good, I think that is absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah.
So he is the son of David, 12 by 73, the heavenly, he's your heavenly shield, you know, he's the shield of David. And he will sort all this out, not us. Now, that was one way on population how you get exponential. The other way is an interest. If ever you've gone to a bank and borrowed £1,000 for a new for a second-hand car or something, they charge you like 8.9% interest, 10%. Credit cards are 18.9%. There was one on the telly the other day, Conduit, 19.8% on a TV advert. I thought, well, trying to get rid of Wanda at 49, and this one's coming along with 99. Anyway, interest is condemned by God. Okay? If Pat would like to read Exodus 22:25.
Exodus
22:25.
Leviticus.
Leviticus 25, chapter.
And verse?
Verses 35, 36, and 37. 35, 36.
Oh,
goodness, go on. So then, as John said, David is saying, who will stay in the house of the Lord? He that doesn't do that. So, interest. This is my, one's from the New Scientist, which is an awful evolutionist magazine, how it works compound wise. If you borrow a pound of somebody, okay, and you say in 1 year I want the money back. If there's no interest, 0% interest, you borrow a pound, you pay back a pound. Okay? If you say a pound, I'll give you 100% interest, end of the year you pay back the £1 plus the 100% on top is £2, okay? So you've got to pay back £2 on a pound. Now, that's if the interest is calculated annually. But sometimes the interest can be calculated differently. So if it's calculated half yearly, after half a year, you gain 50p, haven't you, half of a pound. But for the second half of the year, you pay the 50% on the pound plus on the 50p interest. So you end up paying £2.25 back. So the first one you pay £2 back annually, half a year you pay £2.25. If it was calculated monthly at the end of every month for you, though, you'd go boom, 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 and you'd end up paying back £2.61. Okay? Because they're at interest monthly.
Well, sometimes it's daily, isn't it?
Yeah, well, let's put it that. So then you can get daily, which is £2.718.28. Okay? Now, that is the exponential, okay? If you do something on one, it's different on other numbers. On one, an exponential comes out of 2, 7, 1, 8, 2, 8. And Euler, he's written there, where is it? No, 2, 1, 8, 7, 8 is about what it would be if it was daily, okay? Now you could calculate interest hourly, monthly, or by a second, okay?
Oh.
Now this exponential number goes on infinitely. You can do it by the half second. But basically, if you, once you put interest into something, you're destroying the capital values. I mean, the countries now, what do they owe in GDP?
Oh, that's ridiculous.
I mean, if you think that is a £1 billion bailout by a bank, but it shows you the damage of what interest does does to money. Okay, it's okay for savers, but they're using money to make money, but it's on the back of the poor and the ones that are in debt, which isn't what God wants, is it? Right. Now, I did want Terry here for this, because that 0.71828, okay, means that your pound is now 1 plus 1.718. Now, what's 1 plus 7? 8. Right. Add another one on.
9.
I wanted her for a computer to tell what Hooters number was to 15 decimal places. Well, she's not here, so I'll tell you. Right. Then it goes to 8 1 8 2 8 4 5 9 0 4 5. So that is it. Got really, really fine art of 15 decimal places. Now, what's 1 plus 7?
8.
Plus 1?
9.
Plus 8?
17.
Plus 2?
19.
Plus 8?
Plus 8, did you say? That's 27.
Plus 1?
29.
Plus
28.
Plus 8?
36.
Plus 2?
38.
38.
Plus 8?
46.
Plus 4?
50.
Easy one. Plus 5?
55.
Plus 9?
64.
Plus 4?
68.
So what's the chances of it going up and up to 73? 1 in 10. You need a 5 to do that, wouldn't you? Right? But it adds up to 73. Okay? So that's what that is for the 50 decimal points. Adding them up one at a time. Okay? Now this is where it gets even better than that and that. Mathematics, I don't know. If I understand the Holy Spirit, what would you call that? A threesome, wouldn't you?
A triunity,
long head, so there's three. So let's just take the decimal points. I think we're doing a new one.
Yeah.
And we got 2, 8, 1. But bear in mind, Euler didn't even know this, the man who worked out what it was. 8 2 8 4 5 9 0 4 5. Yeah. So when we added them up in division, we had 7 plus 1 plus 8. It came to 73, didn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Let's add them up. 5, because that's grace, and God will raise us up to heaven when he's been destroyed all the others. So he raised Noah up with the 5 of the lives. So 8, 1,
9,
plus 8,
17,
plus 9,
26,
26,
plus 5,
31.
3 plus 1,
4, 12,
12, 12
14,
19, 23.
So
we carry 2 behind. 2 plus 7?
9, 11, 19, 23.
2,331. And what did we say? 777 plus 777 was? 1,331. It says, that's God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost. In the exponential number.
Incredible.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah.
Mm. I just think, what a...
I blew your socks off, wasn't it?
What a creation. Here's the mathematical equation for working out an exponential graph. X plus 1 plus all this, okay?
Mm.
That's the exponential theorem, okay? That was written in 1930. It was discovered about the 17th century by Euler, a Swiss mathematician. And we have base 10, which is like 10, 20, 30, 40, but you can have a base 8, Napierian, they call it, Napierian. And that's what logarithms, remember cosines, sines and tangents?
Yeah.
It's all complicated, but that's what they were based on. But they have a formula for working out how something grows exponentially. But in that exponential graph is God. Do you know what I mean? The numbers give out God. The 777777 plus 777 to the 73rd. It's like, it's wow. I just came out as 12 with 73 on top of that. It's just. I'm not saying you have to understand the mathematics, because that's quite complicated. But what I'm saying is that God is written into the mathematics.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I hope you can see. So all that mathematics was there.
So I kept this because I love maths, and it showed that 2718 was the same number I noticed had come out on there.
So we then took it to 15 decimal places, which gave you the 73, but then it gives you God 777. It's like,
what are you taking as?
That's on one, x equals 1. On something else, it would be a lot higher.
Yeah. X equals 1.
If x equals 1, then it's 1 plus 1.7.
That's day.
We made it up doing that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, no, we can't. See, what I'm trying to say is the further you go on it, the more it goes up, doesn't it?
Yeah.
The more quicker you add the interest, the quicker the debt accumulates, if you like. Yeah. So I'm trying to point out it goes up quicker by the second, by the minute, than the hour. And it doesn't go up at all handily. But really, we shouldn't be adding any on this, what I'm trying to
do. No. So can we safely say that the banks are in trouble then?
Yeah. I mean, they said RBS just paid a dividend. Why didn't they pay a debt to the taxpayer first before they paid the dividend?
Good point.
We're 60-odd% owned. So why give all the shareholders tuppence each when they didn't pay it out, did they? The government bailed out the taxpayer's money.
Interesting.
In America now, they think they can print more money, add more interest on, and you make money. No, you destroy everything by adding more interest on.
Then Mugabe said, you can never run out of money, you just print more.
What an ignorant.
Totally. That's what happened in Zimbabwe, where they cut six noughts off